12 a game, and then they got, you know, Diabonte, the big fella down low, averaging about 15 points and six boards in his previous five. They've done a concerted effort of trying to throw it into him and get him going, because he's been their most consistent and most efficient scorer. So there's three guys right there that can really keep you in the basketball game, and then, you know, kind of role players in terms of Chase Adams, a really good point guard, can really find guys. And if you don't locate him and get him stopped in transition, he can push it right up your back. And a guy like Jacob Tryon, and number 20, didn't play against us, Farron's son, didn't play against us up there. But those are two four men that can really shoot it. And Tryon, he's big body. He can go down and post. Like, they got some pieces. And we're going to have to play good to win this basketball game.
Pacific took the first contest in Portland, 65-55. And in that game, Danis Jenkins got going really early, and he stayed consistent. And Danis has told us on the post game, you know, he's a guy that if he does get going early, he tends to feel it the rest of the game. Do you feel like you can get him going in the same way that he was going back on the 15th of January?
You know, and we don't really run anything in particular to try and get him going. That's just maybe a freshman kind of being a freshman, you know, in a sense of, like, we tell all of our guys to come out being aggressive, you know, find the open man. If you're the open man, let her. Percent 5.23s. If we can do that, we'll win this basketball game, because they can't score enough twos to beat you. But if you let this team come out and shoot 40% from three like they were doing earlier in the year and make nine threes, they're going to be right with you.
Last time on this pregame show, you identified having to guard the three-point line. I just want to say, in that game at San Francisco, 3 for 24, the Tigers held the Dons from beyond the arc. So it worked. In closing, a key or two to victory tonight for the Tigers.
You know, we tied with them on the rebounding battle up there. And I, as a staff, we didn't feel like we gave maximum effort on the glass. We got to come out and do what we do. Every time we've out-rebounded teams, we've played pretty well, and that's kind of our identity, is we got to go after them. We got to chase down loose balls and get extra opportunities there. So winning the rebounding battle, I think we only had 6 offensive rebounds up there. We got to have more than that. And the biggest thing, you know, like I said, we got to limit their three-point shots up there. I think they might have went 1 of 5 from three. If we can replicate that effort, we'll have a successful night tonight.
They indeed went 1 of 5 from three up there. Coach Wicks, good luck tonight, and we'll see you down the road, man.
Thanks, Zach.
Assistant coach Luke Wicks will come back and have the starting lineup opening tip from the Spano Center next. This is Pacific Tigers men's basketball on Fox Sports AM 1280.
From the Jackson Rancheria Resort Traffic Center, Fox Sports AM 1280 traffic.
Good evening. It looks like for the most part, your Thursday afternoon commute is behind you. In Stockton itself, I-5 and northbound pretty slow right now from French Camp Road all the way up to about 8th Street. Down in Ripon, 99 southbound, expect delays as per usual from Jacktone Road down through about Main Street. And then in Modesto, 99 southbound, you're tapping the brakes a little bit from Strandiford down through Crow's Landing.
This report is sponsored by Think It Up.
Hi, I'm Nick Jonas, and I'm here to tell you about Think It Up, a new initiative to activate student-powered, teacher-led learning projects. Students and teachers, how can you spark great learning experiences in your classrooms today? Join us at thinkitup.org.
For more information about contests on this station, go to foxsportsam1280.com/rules.
Lowe's is here to help you update those outdated appliances. And we'll even help you save, too. Because when you shop our President's Day appliance savings event, you can get up to 40% off select appliance special values.
Test one, two, three.
Just $428, $856 for the pair, saving you over $300. Whatever updates you need to make throughout your home today, or any day, do it right for less. Start with Lowe's. Offers valid through 226 U.S. only.
This report is sponsored by Unbound.org.
Here's the latest from the iHeartRadio Weather Center.
We're out of the 30s in the overnight tonight. Clear skies are on the way with an overnight low of 41. Partly cloudy skies coming your way tomorrow and a high of 67.
Fox Sports AM 1280 KWSX. Stockton, Tracy, Manteca.
Sponsored by Bonner & Partners, LLC. Text and data rates may apply.
If you've been keeping an eye on the market, then you know that 5G technology is set to take over the telecommunications sector at any minute. High-speed internet that's 100 times faster than anything available now, powerful enough to enable companies to finally realize the potential of self-driving cars, remote surgery, plus internet access fast enough to download entire movies in just a couple of seconds. The company that manufactures the key component that powers the 5G revolution is the cornerstone of the Near Future Report by analysts Jeff Brown, that shows you the top tech stocks that will help you to invest in the early stages of the 5G revolution. Text the word tech to 76280 now to get the Near Future Report. We'll send you a link to your free video presentation directly to your mobile device or computer. Get in on the ground floor of this 5G revolution with the Near Future Report. You'll learn about the device that every American will need in the early stages of 5G. Text tech to 76280 to see the Near Future Report. Text the word tech to 76280.
You've been listening to the Pacific Tigers pregame show with Zach Bay-Rudy on Stockton's only sports station. Stay tuned for exciting Pacific Tigers basketball. Up next,
sports for the Central Valley
on Fox Sports AM 1280. Welcome to Pacific Courtside Live with Zach Bay-Rudy on Fox Sports AM 1280. The Pacific Tigers, your West Coast Conference team. Here's Zach Bay-Rudy with all the exciting action.
And alongside the great Bob Thomason, Zach Bay-Rudy, glad to have you with us courtside at the Alex G. Spano Center Pacific Tigers men's basketball on Fox Sports AM 1280. The Tigers and the Portland Pilots. Let's give you the starting lineups, and we will start with the visiting Portland Pilots. They are shorthanded, and they are coached by Terry Porter in his fourth season. The Pilots are missing Malcolm Porter, Terry's son, averaging just over 10 points a game. And Quincy Farabee did not make the trip. Either. So Quincy Farabee is out tonight for Portland, and that is what's going on with the Portland Pilots. So we'll see if the Tigers can kind of make some hay here in the early going. But the Pilots will have Chase Adams, Tahiro Diabate, JoJo Walker, Takiula Ferenson, and also Isaiah White. Again, Adams, Diabate, Walker, Ferenson, and White for the Portland Pilots under fourth-year head coach Terry Porter. The Pilots come in with a record of 9-17. They are 1-10 in league. The Pacific Tigers under fourth-year head coach Damon Sotomayor aiming for a 20th win tonight would be really impressive for the Tigers as they are looking to go 20-8 after this game and improve to 8-4 in conference. Jaleel Tripp, the reigning West Coast Conference Player of the Week. Austin Vereen, Justin Moore, James Hampshire, and Danis Jenkins for the Tigers. Again, Tripp, Vereen, Moore, Hampshire, and Jenkins for Pacific. Again, the Tigers are 19-8, 7-4 in league. They are 13-3 at home, and they are winners of four straight. After this game, Pacific will head to St. Mary's on Saturday. The Tigers and the St. Mary's Gales at 5 p.m. on Saturday from McEwen Pavilion in Moraga. And then a week off. Pacific's last home game will be here a week from Saturday versus Santa Clara, a 7 p.m. start. Pacific will finish on the road at LMU and at San Diego. And Coach T, a chance for the Tigers to gather, you would figure, a considerable amount of momentum given the schedule that remains as they move towards Vegas.
Yeah, this is where the part of the season where you want to really concentrate, make sure that you play great basketball so you're building momentum going into the tournament. But the schedule does provide this opportunity, but you got to go out and make it happen by playing great basketball.
The Tigers, again, will take on St. Mary's on Saturday. It's going to be a really interesting game. The Tigers really have never played well there in Moraga. Pacific, I think, stacks up decently against St. Mary's this year. They obviously beat them here in four overtimes at the Spano Center. It'll be interesting, of course, St. Mary's will have that revenge angle to play. But I'm interested to see how the Tigers kind of stack up on the road in Moraga. It's going to be a really nice test.
Yeah, it'll be a good test. I mean, anytime, you know, you beat a team, and it was four overtimes, so either team could have won that game. But sometimes the team that loses makes a little adjustments, where the team that wins sometimes say, well, I got to keep on doing the same stuff. And both teams probably should make some adjustments to make sure they can defend each other. Yeah, but it should be a heck of a game. He'll be playing for at least third place.
Yeah, and maybe, who knows, depending on what happens, an inside track for second place. We shall see. Tonight's officials, Ron Brokenbrough, Coban Lopez, and Nick Carruthers. Portland is wearing black uniforms tonight with the wheel, the Pilot's Wheel logo, on the front of the jersey. It's a purple wheel. Underneath the purple wheel, a white numeral on the back of those black jerseys, a white numeral, the last name of each Portland player written in white, block letters above the numeral on the back, black shorts for the Pilots. The Tigers, the home whites, Pacific written in black, block letters outlined in orange across the chest, a black numeral outlined in orange on the front and the backs of the jerseys, the last name of each Pacific player written in black, block letters on the back of the jersey above the numeral, white shorts and black trim down the sides. James Hampshire and Zahiro Diabate to handle the opening tip. It's going to be controlled by Diabate, who tips it almost out of bounds on the near sideline. But the Pilots, able to gather it in. And they have the first possession. They move from our left to our right. From our vantage point on the far right side of press row next to the Tiger bench, as they slip it down low to Diabate. He misses the layup.
Can't get a better shot than that. Great execution. A little special action. They cross screen inside for a layup.
And Jaleel Tripp wasting no time getting his first rebound as they find Vereen in the far corner for three. It's an air ball overshot by Vereen. And Portland comes away with the basketball. So both teams coming up empty on their opening possession. As Diabate between the circles dribbles to his left. Dribble handoff to Isaiah White. Going to give to JoJo Walker in the corner for three. And that is going to be short. And Jaleel Tripp has his second rebound of the game. Tripp coming into this game, 35 rebounds over his last two games, which is really
another
impressive.
Good shot by Portland. They penetrated, kicked it out for a wide open three.
Tripp given to his right to James Hampshire. Now further right it goes to Justin Moore. Moore enters it right of the lane to Jaleel Tripp. Tripp spins, puts it up off the glass and in, gets fouled. Nice start to this game for Jaleel Tripp.
It's shocking to me how somebody would throw the ball inside to Tripp and then let him go one-on-one. Nobody in the league has stopped him so far. It seems like three guys would be down there triple-teaming to make sure he got that ball out of there.
So Tripp has two rebounds. He now has 2 points and a chance to complete a three-point play. Free throw is up and good. 3-0 Tigers, 18:58 and counting to go here in the first half. From our left to our right go the Pilots, as JoJo Walker gives a bounce pass up top to Tahiro Diabate. Back up top it goes to Ferenson. Ferenson dribbles to his right, hands it off to Isaiah White. White trying to go baseline, spins on Jenkins, puts it up and
very
in over
nice
Danis.
Move. That was pretty good defense. He cut baseline, did a spin move, hit a tough shot.
Yeah, Jenkins was right there with him, and he had his hand up and was careful not to foul and couldn't have been defended any better. As Vereen up top, looking to his left now, bounce pass to his right. Curling is Jenkins. Jenkins going to give a bounce pass to his right. Curling is Moore at the right elbow. Give to Jenkins on the left wing. Jenkins off the dribble. Takes Walker to the baseline. Puts it up around the rim and out. Rebound is taken by Portland. Hampshire had a chance, but Portland comes away with it as Isaiah White in the front court. Up top to Adams. Back to White. White near the point. Dribbling to his right. Toward the right angle. White slings it back up top to Adams. Adams dribbles to his left and now gives to Ferenson. Back it goes on the left wing to Walker. Enters it to Diabate. Puts it up over Hampshire. It's well short. And a rebound taken by Moore. Moore into the front court, across the center court stripe, up the far right sideline. Moore gives to his right to Danis Jenkins. Jenkins back up top to Moore. Moore backpedals with the dribble. Moore being guarded up top by Adams. Moore is going to try and spin it, have his pocket picked, stolen by Diabate. Diabate is all alone and slams it home ahead of the defense.
Good defense by Adams. He's out there pestering Moore. You know, Moore sometimes doesn't like to be pestered that much, you know, pressured. He let it bother him rather than just being bad. Put your body in, back up, dribble up, and be strong with the ball.
Moore in the front court gives a bounce pass to his left to Vereen. Vereen looks to his right now, bounce pass to his left to Jenkins. Extra pass down low, misconnection between he and Jaleel Tripp. Good action, though, and they would have had it.
The pass should have been made. He just threw a little too hard and went out of bounds. I always thought every lob pass should be able to bounce in bounds rather than just go out of bounds.
On the near side, it's Walker up top to Diabate. Diabate dribbling to his left, hands it off to Adams, to Ferenson. Ferenson dribbles to his right, hands it off to Walker. Walker dribbles to his left. He's in the key to Diabate. Diabate hesitation move goes in on Hampshire. Diabate now left of the lane, gives it back out to Walker with eight to shoot. Walker on the far left side, dribbling to his left, drives to the baseline, takes a fadeaway from an impossible angle, and it's an air ball. Loose ball taken by Pacific, trailing 4-3 as we tick towards 16 and a half minutes to go in the first half. Moore to Jaleel Tripp, Tripp to the corner to Vereen. Tripp setting a screen, Vereen using it to his left. Vereen lobs it to Tripp inside the right angle. Tripp's going to drive it to the baseline, and it's going to be a hand check foul called on Portland. It's going to be on JoJo Walker, and the Tigers have the ball side
out.
They
isolated Tripp again about mid-post, 15 feet. Got to him. He just went right to the basket and got fouled.
Baseline right. Moore will inbound. And Moore inbounds to Jenkins inside the right angle. Goes into the lane, tries to dunk it, and he lost a handle on it, but Tripp is there to get the loose ball, put it up and in. Jenkins, I think, wanted to try and dunk it. It slipped out of his hand, and he's having a conversation with Stoudemire right now. But lucky that Jaleel Tripp was there to clean it up.
You think somebody would screen him off, just face guard Tripp. He's such a great offensive rebounder. I would always assign a guy just to face guard him, keep him off the boards. He's doing a great job tonight.
We're going to have to try and figure something out because Jaleel Tripp obviously has been uncontainable in the last couple of games as Adams gives it up top to Isaiah White. White backpedaling now, using a screen to his right. White's going to drive to the baseline, scoop a reverse layup off the glass.
Nice passes. Well, one problem Portland's going to have is they're switching a lot of the screens. So what happens, you can put a good rebounder on him, but then they're switching and getting a guard on him, and there's no way a guard can stop him from rebounding.
It's going to be Moore near the right elbow, pulling it back. Moore guarded well that time. Gives to Vereen, curling to his left. Vereen takes the shot, missed it, but he traveled, so the shot wouldn't have counted anyways.
Well, he shot an air ball, and he's traveling two shot attempts. So as well as he started last game, home game, 2-for-2 for the three, he's been not starting this game as well.
We're going to take us to a timeout on the floor. It comes with 15:33 to go in the first half from the Spano Center. It is Portland 6 and Pacific 5. We're back after this on Fox Sports AM 1280.
In Stockton, Sacramento, and San Francisco, a University of the Pacific student has made a decision to learn, live, and lead with purpose in mind. Here, it's all about moments, moments that change lives, families, communities, economies, the world. At University of the Pacific, these moments give life purpose. They give us purpose, too. After all, we share one future. Join us, University of the Pacific.
To go in the first half. And at Portland 6, Pacific 5, the Pilots do have the ball coming out of this timeout. As from our left to our right goes Chase Adams. Pacific started 2 of 5 from the floor. Portland 3 of 7 as Adams dribbles to his right. Cuts it back across the lane. Shovels it behind to Ferenson. To Adams. Adams at the top of the key drives to his right. Nice ball fake on Moore. Puts it up over Hampshire and knocks
it down.
Nice
time. You know, being so small, he faked and made a spin. He was wide open.
Tigers in the front court. Tripp is up top, dribbles to his right, hands to Danis Jenkins, who moves to his left, hand off to Moore, to Jenkins in the near corner. Jenkins drives baseline. They're going to call an offensive foul, as absorbing the contact was JoJo
that
White.
That was a good call. I mean, the defense did a great job beating the spot. He's got to pull that dribble up one, you know, quicker when he sees that guy right in front of him. And if he backed that dribble up, he can still get that jump shot over him. He's such a good shooter off the dribble.
So the inbound to Adams. Again, the Pilots are shorthanded. They did not make a substitution after the media timeout. Pierre Crockrell has just checked in for Justin Moore. Also, Jabril Price-Noel is on the floor for Pacific. It's dribbling to his right is JoJo Walker to Adams. Adams is going to give to his right to Ferenson. He's going to take a three, and it's off the backboard and out. The rebound taken by Pierre Crockrell.
That might be Portland's first poor shot.
Crockrell's going to drive right of the lane, put a floater up. It's off the mark. Rebound, Hampshire, and he puts it off the glass and in.
Great rebound. Two-hand rebound and quick release.
Adams on the near side. Adams going to give a chest pass up top to JoJo Walker. Now on the left wing to Isaiah White. White dribble one time, give it to Adams, and now in the near corner to JoJo Walker, and a whistle stops play before the shot. And there's going to be a foul here on Portland. It's going to be a legal screen on Tahiru Diabate, the junior from Bamako, Mali.
I think that guy got pushed and he stumbled. They're calling him tripping the guy. I'd like to see that on a replay.
Trip Crockrell, Price Noel, Jenkins, and now Shaquilo Fritz has taken over for James Hampshire. 8-7 Portland by one with 14:05 and counting to go in the opening stanza. On the right wing, it is Jabril Price-Noel, dumps it to Tripp, right of the lane. Tripp goes up with the right hand, puts it up, no, and a rebound taken by Ferenson. That was well guarded that time, as now behind the back goes Adams, slithers to the baseline, leaves a bounce pass to Walker. It's knocked away, but not stolen. Walker will corral it near midcourt. 14 on the shot clock, 13:39 and counting to go in the first half. 10 seconds to shoot as Walker dribbles to his left, slings it back to the right wing to Adams. Off the dribble he goes, cuts to his left, in the key, takes a fadeaway and knocks
nice
it down.
Nice little separate, he's so quick and he knows how to separate himself, create some space.
So a nice shot there by Chase Adams, who has 4 points in the first half. 10-7 Portland. Jenkins dribbles to his left, takes a long two and rattles it home.
Off the dribble is tough.
10-9, Portland's lead is one. From our left to our right, Adams goes into the front court. Adams in the high front court, cuts it to his left, toward the left wing. Now back to his right he goes. Adams to Diabate,
nice,
who lays it up and in.
Pass on the screen and roll.
Screen and roll from Adams to Diabate to make it 12-9 Pilots. Jabril Price-Noel on the right wing, dribbles to his left. Price-Noel is going to look back to his right, give a bounce pass to Crockrell. Crockrell is on the right wing, has nowhere to go, gives it to Price-Noel up top, 10 to shoot. Jabril trying to dribble his way in, spins in the lane. Jabril looking to force it, goes up with the left hand, no. The rebound missed by Fritz, and it pops out to the Pilots. Into the front court, streaking Isaiah White, gives in the right corner to Walker for three. That's off the mark, and Jaleel Tripp clamps the rebound. Up the far right sideline he goes. Tripp cuts it to the middle, goes through two defenders. They're going to call an offensive foul here on Jaleel Tripp. They're going to say that he knocked down Ferenson. Tripp kind of tried to go through both of them. And on the replay here,
not a good call.
I thought it was a flop. Flop back by Ferenson. So Brock Finstone checks in for the
no
Tigers.
Call.
Yeah, I thought it was a no call.
You know, neither one. He went in between the guy. There was a little contact, incidental contact. Just let that game play on.
So the inbound from Jacob Tryon, who's checked in for the first time, to Chase Adams. Adams into the front court to Tryon. Now to the left wing to LeVar Harewood, who is also in for the first time. Now to the right side to Adams. Dribbles to his left, gives it up top to Harewood. Harewood further left to JoJo Walker. Walker drives to the baseline, puts it up, is blocked by Fritz. The putback attempt is denied by Jabril Price-Noel. Diabate tried to put it back, and Price-Noel clamped the putback, and now Crockrell, a nice move in the lane, cuts to the bucket, puts it up and in, and gets fouled.
I thought this should have been a jump ball down here, because I think that the block was like a long block. You know how both guys
talking about Fritz blocking Diabate?
Yeah, I think he blocked it all the way up. To me, that was a jump ball call more than just a block shot. It's not like he blocked the ball, got out of his hand.
Either way, great job by Shaquilo
great
Fritz.
Finish down here.
Yeah, great job by Fritz to deny. He was going to get another look on the replay. Fritz blocked it off the backboard initially, and then.
But this one right here.
It was Price-Noel that had the second block.
See how it goes all the way up? Their both hands are on the ball, and they're on the ball.
Yeah, yeah.
That would be a good ref.
If you see in the replay, especially when you use replay, you'd be fantastic. Timeout on the floor comes with 11:50 to go in the first half. And here at the Spano Center, it is Portland 12, Pacific 11 here on the Pacific Digital Network. 11:50 to go in the first half at the Spanos Center. It's Portland 12, Pacific 11. Pierre Cockrell is at the line to attempt free throws. By the way, if you were looking for our game tonight on Fox Sports AM 1280, they're having some issues back at the station. We are on the stadium in the W.TV. The free throw by Cockrell is short and the rebound taken by Portland. So again, it's not on our end. They're having some satellite issues at the station. So we are with you exclusively on the Stadium Network and the W.TV. As left of the lane, it's Theo Akuba who's checked in, and he turns the ball over. The Tigers come away with a loose ball, and Jabril Price-Noel is not going to have a chance to do anything because away from the ball, there's going to be a foul on Shaquille Fritz for an illegal screen.
He didn't hold the screen long enough. He's got to hold it. He's leaving to go become an offensive player. You know, you want to be an offensive player after you screen, but you got to finish the screen first. And sometimes the defense gets into you, and you got to wait longer. So the discipline you have to have for that.
Adams cuts it up top, gives it to Akuba. Akuba dribbles toward the left angle, gives it to JoJo Walker. Now to Jacob Tryon. Tryon on the right wing hands it to Harewood. Up top to Akuba. Akuba holding on the left wing, gives to Adams. Adams will back it up toward the far left corner. Give it up top to Tryon. Tryon going to lob it down low, and then a whistle stops play. 7 seconds on the shot clock at the time of the whistle. And a foul away from the ball, a hold called on Jabril Price-Noel. And for Pacific, that is their fourth team foul.
But two guys are wrestling in the low post. The defense usually gets the foul call.
Baseline left, it's going to be inbounded by Isaiah White, who then gets it back on the far sideline, guarded by Jeremiah Bailey, who's checked in. To Adams, chest pass to Tryon, the right corner. Tryon dribbles to his left, is going to give it back to his right to Adams. Adams going off the dribble on Cockrell, who's screened out, gets underneath the bucket. He throws it toward the window, but does not draw anything. The loose ball taken by the Tigers. Cockrell pass across the way to Finstoon, steps into a three. It's too strong, and a rebound taken by Portland's Chase Adams. Long rebound. Adams on the far left sideline. Adams moves toward the middle, gives a bounce pass down low that's stolen by Finstoon. Finstoon, a long outlet pass to Price-Noel in transition, dumps it right of the lane to Cockrell, extra pass to Fritz. Fritz swarmed underneath, but somehow gets loose and puts it up in
there. I think he can become a good, effective inside player. He's getting his confidence, his quickness, his timing, and have a little patience. I think he could really score in there.
Right side, it's White, off the dribble to his right, lobs it up top to Akuba. Akuba to his left, hands it off to Adams. Up top to Tryon. Tryon dribbles to his right. Tryon's going to try and take a three, knocked away by Jeremiah Bailey. And now up top to Harewood. And in the hands now of Adams on the left wing. Adams driving to the baseline, puts up a tough shot, odd angle, and it's missed. It's short. The rebound taken by Jeremiah Bailey to Cockrell, who chugs into the front court. Cockrell lobs it baseline to Fritz, who receives, gives it out near corner to Finstoon, a wide open three, and it's off the mark. Rebound almost taken by Bailey, but there's going to be a foul.
Tough call, Bailey. I mean, he went after that ball, but that's the kind of pass you want that ball to go in. When, you know, that was a great lob pass, great catch, pass the three. That ball goes in, the crowd gets into it.
Yeah. Well, I'm confused about the call on Bailey. It's a loose ball foul before
maybe
he got
the
rebound.
Maybe went over the back. I don't know.
Walker up top gives a bounce pass to his left to Akuba. Akuba is on the left wing, and a whistle stops play. And foul's going to be on Brock Finstoon for a hold. So that is the sixth team foul now on Pacific. So one more gets Portland in the 1-1 bonus. Far sideline inbound by Tryon to Walker. Walker is going to give to Tryon up top. Now to Harewood. Harewood guarded by Cockrell. And now on the left side to Walker. Walker guarded by Bailey, who's screened out for a moment. Walker trying to knife his way down low, being denied. Now shimmies toward the baseline, loses a handle on it. Flings it back out to Isaiah White, who splits the defense, puts it up, is blocked by Shaquille Fritz. What a block by Fritz. He is just so long and athletic. Now Cockrell, hesitation move to the baseline. Back up top to Bailey. Bailey to Cockrell. Cockrell on the far side, hands it off to Finstoon. Finstoon to Price-Noel. Back to Finstoon on the right wing. Brock going to dump it down low to Fritz. Shaquille right of the lane, angling his way in up with a left hand. Tough shot. He gets a friendly roll.
Nice roll.
Into the front court goes JoJo Walker. Pacific 15 and Portland 12. And now to Harewood on the right wing. Harewood trying to give it to the far side. Nobody was there, but Tryon was able to come up and save it. And now pass down low to Tryon, who puts it up.
Nice slip screen that time. Good slip screen. The Tigers got to help from the opposite side. Get over there, take a charge, steal that ball.
Bailey on the left wing thought about a three, pulled it back. Now they work it around to the right side to Finstoon. Up top to Price Noel. Jabril will start the dribble to the far right sideline. Hand to Finstoon. Chest pass up top to Bailey. Hands it off to Finstoon, curling to his left. Hand off to Price Noel up top. Price Noel drives down low. Gets tied up for a moment. Puts a floater up. Leaves it well short. And the ball knocked loose by Finstoon, who throws it somehow to the bucket. Puts it up and in. And he's going to the line.
What a great play.
He wasn't even looking. It was like he had eyes in the back of his head.
What a great hustle play. Portland should have got that rebound. They're standing around. The Tigers are going to dominate both ends of the court on the rebounding.
The hustle by Finstoon and a little bit of luck. Wow.
Yeah, but that great play. Great play.
Timeout on the floor comes with 7:56 to go in the first half. Pacific 17, Portland 14. And we're back after this on the W.TV. All right, Tiger fans.
What is our way? Our way is unrelenting. Imposing as the mountaintops to our east, strong as the ocean to our west. Our way is bold, challenged by past achievement, expecting future success. Our way is committed, devoted, passionate. Our way fuels us to be different, to be inspired, to have faith in each other. What is our way? Our way is west.
Zach Bay-Rooney, Bob Thomason, glad to have you with us at the Alex G. Spano Center. See if the Tigers can create some separation here. They lead Portland 17-14. This is Pacific's largest lead, and each team has led by as many as three in this game. Pilots led 12-9, and the Tigers at present time lead 17-14. Pacific in this first half, 8 of 17 from the floor. Portland is 7 of 19. Brock Finstoon with an impressive strip and put back going into the media timeout, and he'll have a chance to complete a three-point
getting
play.
Getting the ball was great. Being able to put it up as he's getting fouled was even better.
He misses the free throw, though, and the rebound taken by Portland. The Tigers are now 1 of 3 from the line. Our left to our right, it's JoJo Walker. Walker, off a screen to his left, gives far angle to Isaiah White. White guarded by Finstoon. In the lane, or in the key, dumps to Diabate. He gets it down further to Tryon, and he missed the shot badly. A nice working of the ball down low to Tryon, but he couldn't do anything with it. Is now Gary Chavichian in for the first time. Gives it to Bailey left side, and now up top to Crockrell. Crockrell to Chavichian, to his right to Finstoon, who's near the point right now. Finstoon bounce pass to his right to Crockrell. 10 seconds to shoot to Chavichian on the right wing. Right up on him is Isaiah White. Now to Crockrell on the left wing. Crockrell is going to try and work it in. Crockrell, nice move to his right. Puts up a floater and knocks it down.
If he can become efficient on those little pull-up shots, he can be a tough player.
So now this is the largest lead for either team. 19-14 Pacific as we tick under 7 minutes to go in the first half. Walker is backpedaling toward the near sideline. Up top to Diabate. Diabate slips a bounce pass down low to nobody except Brock Finstoon. Steal for the Tigers. Crockrell spinning in the lane. Crockrell, no-look dish to Bailey. Bailey thought about passing across to Fritz, but wasn't there. Nice job by JB to pull it back down. And now to Crockrell on the right wing. 16 to shoot. Crockrell bounce pass to Bailey, who elevates, scoops it up, and it won't go off the back iron. The ball is loose out of bounds. Last touched by Portland, they say, with...
That was a really nice shot by Bailey. He kind of went around the defense a bit. Got kind of a tough roll where he didn't go in, but, man, that was a nice play inside.
This will be a 20-second reset on the shot clock. Cut. Baseline left, Crockrell will look to inbound. Nice no-look bounce pass inbound to Brock Fitzsooner, who puts it off the glass.
Anybody like that for a layup at this time of the year is ridiculous. You know, you have a guy on the ball, you get the guy out there under the basket, get your head on the basket, and stop those shots.
21-14
poor defense
now.
Right there.
21-14 Pacific. Again, the Tigers working on their largest lead as White dribbles into the lane, tries to work his way down low and gets fouled as he was twisting and turning in the lane, and the foul is on Brock Finstoon. And that'll get Danis Jenkins off the bench for Pacific. Isaiah White, his first free throw is up and good.
He's got to get more involved. He's had a couple nice moves tonight. It seemed like they forget about him.
Who's this, Danis?
No, White.
Oh, Isaiah White, beg your pardon. White, a 77% free throw shooter. Five points for White, and he leads the way for the Pilots. Pacific being led right now by Jahleel Tripp, who's on the bench. Tripp has 5 points and four rebounds. Second one is up and good, so White makes them both. It's 21-16 Pacific. Tripp, by the way, just getting some rest. He's not in foul trouble or anything. He just has one foul. As Jenkins dribbles up top, guarded by Ferenson. Jenkins looking to his right, gives a bounce pass to Chavichian. Back to Jenkins. 14 to shoot. Now to Crockrell on the left wing. Pierre dribbles to his right, goes into the lane. Floater with the right hand. Yes.
Tough shot again.
23-16 Pacific. 5:40 and counting to go in the first half as Walker near the right angle. Chest pass up top to Diabate and a whistle away from the ball. And there's going to be a foul called on Pierre Crockrell. So Jacob Tryon is going to the line, and this is 1-1. Tryon is a 77% free throw shooter. Right now, Damon Sotomayor giving Crockrell some coaching points on what's going on the defensive side and why he's getting himself tangled up down there.
Well, they're switching. He has to go in the low post on a big guy, and he's fighting him really hard. And little guys are going to get a foul once in a while inside there. There's no ifs, ands, and buts about it.
Tryon missed the front end of the 1-1, and then Crockrell, as he was blowing by the defense, was stopped by a whistle, and there's going to be a foul called here on Chase Adams. He was away from the ball.
If I didn't want my guard fouling the big guy inside, I wouldn't switch the screen, so we have to go guard that guy inside. And the guy's 6'10", and you're 5'11". It's tough in there, and Cockrell's doing a great job.
So Jahleel Tripp back on the floor for Jeremiah Bailey as they find Jenkins up top. Jenkins dribbles to his right. Jenkins slings it up top to Tripp, and now the left wing to Crockrell. Feigns an entry pass, dribbles to his right, tries to sling it back to Tripp. It's nearly intercepted, and then is by Ferenson, who then stepped on the sideline. So there was no, they're going to say there was change of possession. They're going to check the shot clock here.
Yeah, he got it, and he stepped out of bounds. Tripp would have stole it anyway, but Tripp tried to dribble that loose ball instead of going and getting it with two hands.
So this is a fresh 30-second shot clock, as they said, change possession. As up top, it's Tripp. Now in the right wing to Crockrell. Pierre, chest pass to Chavichi, and turnaround three, tough fading away three, and he knocks it down.
Well, that's a tough shot, but he has a lot of confidence, and he knows he's coming off those screens. He knows he's not playing that much. He might as well let it fly.
Ferenson dribbling to the right elbow. Is back to the hoop. Ferenson's going to shovel it to Adams. Adams dribbles to his left. Chest pass to Walker, and now on the left wing to Tryon. Tryon hands to Ferenson. Ferenson to the left corner to Adams. Adams dribbles to his right. Adams fakes a shot and then tries to lean into a pass that's stolen by Tripp. On ahead to Crockrell. Behind the back pass to Jahleel. Goes into the defense. Puts it up. No, but he traveled. Kind of an awkward reception there by Tripp on that behind-the-back pass.
Cockrell's being a little too cute with it. You know, he gave it to him too early, so then he ended up shuffling his feet to gather himself with the player. Keep things simple. You know, get a good shot. You had a three-on-one, three-on-two fast break. You want to get a good shot.
Fourth, 29 and counting to go in the first half. And from our left to our right, Chase Adams into the front court. Adams moves to his left where he hands it off to Isaiah White. White crosses over, goes down left of the lane. Ball fake, fadeaway is no good. Rebound taken by Jahlil Tripp. That's his fifth. Tripp up the far right sideline. Tripp is going to blow by the defense and scoop it off the window and in. I think the defense thought he was going to leave it for Chavichian, and they were fooled.
He's the best player on the court. Guard him first, you know, then worry about the other guys second.
Pacific is opening it up now. 28-16 Tigers as Adams on the left wing. Hesitation move, scoots to the tin, puts it off the glass and in. 10-point game, 28-18 with 3:45 and counting to go in the first half. Crockrell across the center court stripe. Tigers are 6 of their last 7 from the floor. Crockrell up top to Tripp. Back to Crockrell on the right side. Pierre guarded by Adams, gives a pass to Chavichi in the far right corner, dribbles to the right angle, takes a three that misses badly, tripped there for the rebound, puts it up and misses the bunny. And the rebound taken by Portland. A rare miss from short range by Jahlil Tripp, but he does get his sixth rebound on that. Is on the right wing, it's Walker, curls into the lane, Walker scoots toward the bucket, puts it up and in, and he gets fouled. Nice move to the bucket by Walker, and the foul is going to be on James Hampshire. So that will take us to another timeout on the floor here in the first half. This timeout comes with 3:08 to go in the first half. It's Pacific 28, Portland 20 on the W.TV.
Section 105, which is down on the floor. The gentleman is now standing up. He's wearing a Pacific sweatshirt. We would like to recognize John Liu as our season ticket holder of the game. On behalf of Lincoln Center,
Zach Bayrudy, Coach T, glad to have you with us on the W.TV. Again, they were having some technical issues if you were trying to catch us on Fox Sports AM 1280 and on iHeartRadio. They were having some issues back at the station, not on our end, but we are glad to be with you on Stadium and the W.TV nonetheless. And JoJo Walker is at the line, and he'll try and complete a three-point play. It's 28-20, Pacific by 8. Free throw is up and good. So it's a 7-point spread, 28-21. The Tigers leading by 7 is Moore in the front court. Hands to Jenkins, now to Chavichian. Chavichian back to Jenkins on the left wing. Jenkins spinning to his right. Gives a bounce pass to Moore, curling toward the left elbow, now back pedals. Moore is on the left angle, switches directions, goes to the baseline, forces it off the glass and in.
Good job, good drive. Got size on the guys guarding him and took advantage of it.
30-21, Pacific by 9 is up top. It's Tryon, gives to his left to Isaiah White. White drives right of the lane, puts it up and in off the glass.
I don't know why he doesn't shoot more and get more touches for their team. I mean, he's been tough every time he's had the opportunity to score.
Isaiah White with 8 points now. As up top, it's Jenkins. Now to Moore on the right wing. Moore dribbles to his left. Moore, chest pass to Chavichian. A 3 from the right wing is going to be too strong, and the long rebound pops out to Isaiah White. Our left to our right go the Pilots. Chase Adams across the center court stripe on the far side. Adams cuts it back to his left. Adams trying to work around Hampshire. He does, but keeps the basketball. Doesn't attempt a shot. Now Adams going to pull up from the free throw line. His shot goes nowhere. The rebound, Tryon tried to save it as it was going out of bounds, but he stepped out of bounds while he was touching the ball. And with a minute 55 to go in the first half, Jeremiah Bailey and Austin Vereen check in for James Hampshire and Gary Chavichian. So it's Tripmore, Vereen, Bailey, and Jenkins on the floor for the Tigers. Moore across the center court stripe to the far right sideline, up top to Bailey. Bailey dribbles to his left, gives to Jenkins. Jenkins drives down the middle, splits the defense, scoops it off the window and in.
Great drive. You know, when I was coaching, if guy went down the lane and went off 1 foot and made a layup against your half-court defense, I wasn't a happy camper.
Can't imagine Terry Porter is right now either, as White drives down the lane, runs into Vereen, and it's going to be... it's going to be a blocking foul on Vereen. I would, and we will. It's going to be a blocking foul on Vereen, and two free throws are coming. For Isaiah White.
I hope his foot was in the circle, because if it wasn't in front of the circle, it had to be a charge.
I thought Vereen did a great job there.
Yeah.
Establishing position. Free throw is up and good for White. Second one up and no good. It rims out. The rebound taken by Jeremiah Bailey. Hands it off to Justin Moore. Moore from our right to our left into the front court. Moore dribbles toward the far sideline, gives a bounce pass up top to Bailey, and now on the left wing to Jenkins. Jenkins to Tripp. Tripp to Vereen on the right wing. Vereen up top to Bailey. 13 to shoot to Moore on the left wing. Moore to Tripp. Now on the right side to Jenkins. Jenkins, six to shoot, is going to take the three, and it's too strong. Long rebound, though, comes out to Bailey as we tick under a minute. He's going to take a three. He nails it, but... he traveled.
He changed his pivot foot or what?
I don't know. But Coban Lopez says that he traveled. So under a minute to go, it's 32-24. Pacific by eight as Walker chest pass to his left to Tryon. Tryon dribbles to his right. Tryon's going to hand it off to Walker. Walker is up top. Walker lobs it down low to Tryon, blocked nicely by Jenkins and stolen. That pass was denied by Jenkins, and then he did a nice job to come away with the loose ball. As Tripp drives baseline, and there's going to be no shot here. Foul's on the floor, but this will put Pacific in the 1-1 bonus. This is going to be a foul on Takiula Ferenson. So Tripp will be at the line. He's made Pacific's only made free throw of the half. Pacific one of three from the line this half. Needs to make the first to take the second. It's up and good. So Jaleel will indeed get another with 30.8 seconds to go. So 8/10 of a second separate the game clock from the shot clock. Second one for Tripp is up and good. So it's a 10-point game, 34-24. Pacific, and now Moore steals the inbound pass. So the Tigers can hold for the last shot of the half as Moore steals the inbound. And now is hanging out near midcourt to Tripp on the far side.
Well, there's no way the guy guarding Tripp can stop him from penetrating.
That would be Tryon right now at a good distance as 9 seconds to go in the half. And we'll see what Tripp wants to do here. Tripp maybe going to try and get downhill. Instead, he gives to Moore on the left wing. Moore shot fake, goes in the lane, puts up a floater. No, gets his own miss, puts it back. And no, they say no good. I'm not sure it would have counted. Obviously, it didn't go in.
I don't
in.
Think the putback would have counted. I think the ball was in his, the light was on with the ball.
Well, my question is, and we encountered this a couple weeks ago, wasn't there 8/10 of a second that separated the shot clock? Or no, that was after the free throw, right?
Yeah, so I think when he stole it, it was probably under 30 seconds, you know what I'm saying?
Because I thought he stole the inbound pass, which would leave 8/10 of a second.
Well, maybe he did.
I don't know. It's interesting because a couple weeks ago we had that same scenario where we had fractions of a second And I remember talking to, I forget the official that was here at the time, but I ran over and asked.
Tony Padilla?
Tony Padilla.
Yeah.
And, yeah, well, apparently there was not 0.8 seconds left. In any event, a nice finish to the first half for the Tigers, who lead by 10 at intermission. We're going to take a four-minute break, and when we come back, Coach C and I will have all the numbers from the first half. Our score at halftime, Pacific 34, Portland 24. And we're back after this on the W.TV. Back at the Alex G. Spano Center, Zach Bay-Rudy, Coach T, Bob Thomason, glad to have you with us as our score at halftime, Pacific 34 and Portland 24. Coach, I thought, you know, it was maybe a little bit of a slow start over the first 8 to 10 minutes or so, but a nice job by the Tigers gaining that double-digit separation at the end of the half. I thought especially the last 4 minutes of the half, Pacific played really well, and they made some great hustle plays.
Yeah, the last 10 minutes they played well. Except for a travel, three-point shot, maybe a free throw or two, they're not shooting the ball from three very well or the free throw line, and they got too many turnovers. I mean, really, for this point, to turn the ball over that much against Portland. But if I was Portland, I'd be happy to be down 10 the way they play.
Yeah.
I don't think Portland's very deep, very good, and you're still in the game. Pacific needs to come out here and get this lead to about 18 real quick and then maintain it, maybe even increase it a little more.
Well, and to add to that, again, Portland is shorthanded tonight without Malcolm Porter and without Quincy Farabee. Let's give you the numbers from the first half, and we'll start with the Tigers. Jahlil Tripp with 9 points and 6 rebounds. Tripp, 3 of 5 from the floor, 3 of 3 from the line, and I think you said it best. There's really nobody out there on the floor for Portland right now that can guard Jahlil Tripp.
No, but what they need to do is shade to him and go help him and get the ball out of his hand. And when he does get the ball in the low post, go double him, make other players beat you. And if they do, that's great. But you don't want him having the kind of night he's having inside.
Pierre Crockrell had a nice half. 6 points on 3 of 4. Pierre was 0 of 1 from the line. 3 assists and no turnovers for Crockrell. So Pierre had a nice half with 6 points, and he was very active. You know, he starts getting those angles, getting into the lane to where he can make that floater. And if he has that floater in the pull-up game going, he can be really tough.
Yeah, you know, he played a very good half. Those aren't easy shots. He practices them a lot. He's getting better at them. The one little behind-the-back pass, yeah, I'm not an opponent against lob passes or behind-the-back passes. I just like to do them in the essence of winning, not to be like – to have people show me they could do it. And I thought he gave the ball to Tripp way too early, you know, and then Tripp traveled in there. People don't think that's a big play, but you need to go score those plays, because at the end of the game, you lose this game by one, that's a big play.
Sure.
And so the difference between, you know, winning and being a little flamboyant, those are things that the coach knows more than anybody else and the player knows. That's why you can talk about those things. I don't think you can turn those on and off as a player. You know, you just need to find that way to continue to play. And it's not because he will throw those passes, because he's clever and he's going to see it. But sometimes it's the right time to make that pass.
So after that, 4 points for 3 different players. Brock Finstone on 2 of 4. Shaquilo Fritz, 2 of 2. Fritz also had 4 rebounds in that half. And also 4 points for Danis Jenkins on 2 of 5. 3 points for Gary Chavichian, 1 of 3 from beyond the arc. And then 2 points for James Hampshire on 1 of 1. 2 points for Justin Moore on 1 of 2. The Tigers in the first half, 15 of 30, very nice, 50%. From beyond the arc, Pacific is 1 of 7. And from the free throw line, the Tigers are 3 of 5. The other side for Portland, the Pilots were led by Isaiah White, 9 points on 3 of 5. He was 3 of 4 from the line. Coach, I know you like the way Isaiah White plays. You think they need to create more for him?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, I think he needs to put the ball in his hands and create for his teammates and let him go to town, because I thought he did a great job and he's hard to guard.
6 points after that for Chase Adams on 3 of 6. I thought Adams had a pretty good first half. After that, Tahiro Diabate had 4 points on 2 of 4. 3 points for JoJo Walker on 1 of 5, and 2 points for Jacob Tryon on 1 of 3. Again, there's just not much depth here tonight for Portland. The Pilots played 8 guys in that first half. And again, it really hurts that they're missing Malcolm Porter, who averages just over 10 points a game. The Pilots were 10 of 25 from the floor, 40%, 0 of 4 from outside, 4 of 6 from the line. Turnovers, the Tigers turned the ball over 8 times. Portland had 4 points, beg your pardon, off of 8 Tiger turnovers. The Pilots turned the ball over 7 times. Pacific generated 8 points off of those Pilot turnovers. Points in the paint, Pacific 26-16 with the advantage. Second chance points, Pacific 6, Portland with none. Fast break points, even at 2 apiece. And the Pacific bench, obviously much deeper than the Portland bench, and they outscored the Portland bench 17-2. No ties. There were four lead changes. The Tigers led the majority of that half for 12 and a half minutes. The Pilots did lead for just under 6.5 minutes. You know, do you see a way for Portland to win this game tonight? And I ask it in that way because this feels like, especially coming in, this felt like a game the Tigers should probably win. Given the absence of Malcolm Porter especially, it really looks like a game the Pacific can have. But is there something that you've seen from Portland that would lead you to believe they could win this game tonight?
No, I don't. I mean, when I say no, that doesn't mean it can't happen.
Yeah.
But I just don't see it. They can't rebound with the Tigers on either end. They don't shoot the ball. I mean, it's not like their three-point shooting is really good where they could get hot the second half. They don't have an inside game, you know, presence. And the Tigers played good the last 10 minutes, but, you know, they can play a lot better than they played. So I think it's a lot more chance to be a 20-point game than it's going to be. I mean, I'd be shocked.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah, as would I. That being said, still another half of basketball to play. We're going to take a 2-minute break, and when we come back, we'll have some scores from around the WCC. And we'll also take a look at what's to come as the Tigers will head to Moraga on Saturday to take on St. Mary's. That'll be a big one, of course. Pacific one half of basketball away from a fifth straight win is our score at intermission. Pacific 34 and Portland 24. We're back in 2 minutes with the start of the second half on the W.TV. Back courtside at the Spano Center, Zach Bayrudy, Bob Thomason. We are just moments away from the start of the second half. Let's take a look at some out-of-town scores on the WCC out-of-town scoreboard. And there's one game that has just gone final. San Francisco wins at Santa Clara 70-61. At one point, Santa Clara went 11 minutes without a field goal in that game. Josip Vrankic went 0-10 from the floor in that game.
Wow.
So big win, obviously, on the road for the Dons, and a tough home loss there for the Broncos. A game that is two games that are moments away from the opening tip. BYU at LMU, and that'll be starting momentarily, as will San Diego at Pepperdine. So that is what is on tap around the West Coast Conference and on the out-of-town scoreboard. It will be interesting to see the outcomes of both of those games. I think, you know, for BYU, they usually have a game where they'll slip. You know, a lot of times it's been at Pepperdine. Sometimes it has been at LMU. But I'm interested to see if BYU comes out and means business tonight because they can't afford to slip up.
I'll be surprised. I think BYU is kind of caught themselves now and know how they want to play. They're kind of fighting for their lives in postseason play, and they have a good record, and they want to be at least that second seed with those byes. So I'd be very surprised. I think they have a good team.
Tigers will start the second half with the ball, and they'll move from our left to our right as Justin Moore in the front court lobs it to his right to Jaleel Tripp, who hands to Danis Jenkins. Jenkins bounce pass to Justin Moore, dumps it down low to Tripp. Tripp is on the lower right block, backing his way in on Ferenson, and he puts it up and in.
They should run that play every time down the court.
Now Portland.
Portland can stop it.
Beg your pardon, Coach. Portland moving from our right to our left. Tripp now with 11 points. Becoming the first scorer to reach double figures in this game. Tripp, 11 points and 6 rebounds. Sidi Abate rolling into the lane, trying to take Hampshire to the tin, puts it up over Hamp, and it's no good. And a rebound taken by Pacific. Tripp up the far left sideline. Tripp is on the left wing. Chest pass up top to Moore. Moore back to Tripp on the left angle. Jaleel holding the ball between his knees, dribbles in and stumbles a bit, but keeps his balance, puts it off the glass and in, and he's going to the line. He got hit on the back of the head.
Keep on going to the well.
Foul's going to be on
Tequila Ferenson. And they don't have one guy that can guard him. Just keep on going. Pound that thing in until they force a double team. Then he can pass the ball for an easy shot.
38-24 Pacific, and now Tripp with 13 points. Chance to get 14 with a free throw here. Free throws up, and it is off the front of the rim, but there's going to be a lane violation here on Ferenson, so Tripp will get a second chance. 20th double-digit scoring performance for Jaleel Tripp this season. Most certainly in the running to be a first-team All-League player, so the free throw is up and good, so Tripp makes the most of his second opportunity. 39-24 Pacific as Adams across the PowerCal logo at center court. Adams chest pass to the right side to Isaiah White. White enters it to Diabate. Diabate going into Hampshire, and they're going to call travel. I think they could have also called an offensive foul. I thought Diabate kind of shoved off on him with the ball. But they called the travel. So no matter how you cut it, it's turnover for the Pilots, and the Tigers will get the ball back. Leading 39-24 and really a chance to create some substantial separation here.
Pilots are in a zone defense now for the first time.
Justin Moore on the right wing. Moore bounce pass right of the lane to Tripp, who turns around, leaves the shot short, but gets his own miss. Tripp his seventh rebound. And now Tripp has it on the right wing after a 20-second reset on the shot clock. Danis Jenkins on the far side, up top to Justin Moore, steps into a three, and it's off to the right, and the rebound is going to be taken by Ferenson. Across the way to Isaiah White. White into the front court, into the lane, tries to kick it back out. It's stolen by Tripp. Tripp one-on-one with Adams. Tripp blows by him and puts it off the glass.
Inside out dribble and just faked him all the way to the side.
And Terry Porter wants a timeout. So Jaleel Tripp now with 16-7. And the Tigers have come out hot in the second half. And it looks like they want to leave the Pilots in the dust early in this one. Is this timeout on the floor? Comes with 18:07 to go in the second half. Pacific 41 and Portland 24. And we're back after this on the W.TV.
This moment in Stockton, Sacramento, and San Francisco, a University of the Pacific student has made a decision. A decision to learn, live, and lead with purpose in mind. Here, it's all about moments. Moments that change lives, families, communities, economies, the world. At University of the Pacific, these moments give life purpose. They give us purpose, too. After all, we share one future. Join us, University of the Pacific.
Tigers have opened the second half on a 7-0 run and lead the Pilots 41-24. Beg your pardon, Zach Bayrudy, Coach Bob Thomason. And a nice start here to the second half of the Tigers. What you want
keep,
to see.
And you want to keep it going. You just want to keep this thing going from beginning to end. Just punish people as much as you can. It's all about execution, playing great defense, and sharing the ball.
Adams is near the top of the circle. Chest pass to his left to Walker. JoJo Walker, the junior from Carolina, Puerto Rico, is going to try and get to the baseline. He does. And they're going to call foul on Jaleel Tripp for a little shove.
That was a good call. Sometimes you get beat, you just got to let it go and rely on your help defense to come over there and help somebody.
Baseline left, Isaiah White will trigger it in. Ron Brokenbroth saying to, I'm not sure who, but he's saying knock it off to someone, either Tripp or Diabate, who are kind of tangled down there. Inbound to Diabate, short left corner, hands it back to White, who's guarded by Tripp. White chest pass up top to Adams, now on the right side, they get it to Ferenson. Back to Adams. Adams going to shimmy on Moore, drive into the lane, and they're going to call a hand check foul here on Justin
Moore.
I don't like
that call at all
either.
Because he's in front of him. The guy barely bumps him. He's going to go the other way, and they call a blocking foul. Come on. What do you want him to do, get out of the way, let him lay it up?
That's always the question, isn't it? Like, what do you want the defender to do in that instance?
There's no reason you have to call that call. The other coach, nobody cared.
He's going to be back-to-back fouls here, and this is going to be on Jaleel Tripp, and
you
that's his third.
Yeah, Tripp is painted. He's making the refs look at him because of the pushing and shoving they're doing before the play. And so the eyes go to him. He needs to not do that. They switched out Tripp off that guy, too. That was a good play.
Baseline left. It'll be lobbed into Diabate. Now to Walker, who tries to get it down low, and it's knocked away and stolen. I want to say Tripp was the one that knocked it away. Now Tripp with the ball, gets to the right angle. Shimmy's using a Hampshire screen, gets to his left, passes to his right to Jenkins. And a foul away from the ball on Portland.
Jenkins should have passed the ball inside that time. He had the guy sealed for an easy shot. He's dribbling the ball. He should have been passing the ball inside to Hampshire.
The foul is going to be away from the ball on Isaiah White. So baseline right, Moore is going to inbound, and Moore lobs the inbound to Vereen. Vereen to Jenkins, and now in the high front court to Moore. Back to the left wing to Vereen. Bounce pass to Tripp is knocked away, and they're going to say last touched by Jaleel.
So I don't like those bounce passes from wing to the short corner right there. It's a slow pass. They're playing against the zone. It got sloppy that second.
Left side, it's White. Chest pass up top to Ferenson. Ferenson dribbles to his right. Chest pass to White, now to Walker, now to White, getting down low, and they're going to call a foul on Austin Vereen. The second foul on Vereen.
Hey, nice back cut that time.
So Jaleel Tripp will check out. Jeremiah Bailey is in. And the inbound to Walker, short left corner. He'll take a fadeaway, and it rattles in. So Portland nearly 3 minutes to get their first points of the second half. It's 41-26. Pacific is on the right wing. It's Jenkins. Thought about a skip pass, and now they'll work it around Vereen. Vereen up top to Moore. To Vereen on the left wing for three, and that's around the rim and out. Rebound by Ferenson. On a head up the near sideline to JoJo Walker. Walker's going to explode to the baseline, throw it toward the backboard. It does not go, but he is fouled, and the foul's going to be on Danis Jenkins. So right now the fouls are really accumulating on Pacific. That is the fifth team foul this half, and we're not even at the under 16 media timeout.
Yeah, that could be a problem here if Portland can get to the free throw line and start shooting free throws. Seems like Portland, if they make these free throws, they throw a little press at the Tigers, trying to stir them up and maybe get an easy basket.
Free throw is up and good for Walker. Sixth point for Walker, who's 2 of 2 now from the line. Second one up and good. Nice touch on those free throws by Walker.
Here's the press.
You called it, Coach, as Portland's going to get in the backcourt as Bailey slaps the basketball to inbound to Danis Jenkins. Jenkins to Bailey. Bailey back to Jenkins on the near side. 5 seconds to get it across. Back to Bailey, who does cross the timeline and hand to Moore. Moore chest pass to Chavichian. Now up top to Moore. Chest pass to Jenkins, right corner. Danis dribbles and then passes to his left to Moore. Now back to Jenkins. A right wing three is off the mark. It was nice and on balance by Jenkins. And now a strip from behind by Jeremiah Bailey. Took it away from JoJo Walker. Chavichian far corner. He's open for three, and it's off the mark. Rebound, Bailey. He puts it up. Was underneath the cylinder. No, but he does get fouled, and Jeremiah Bailey did it all on that possession.
Might have got fouled in the legs or something, but he sure didn't get fouled up top because he just hit the ball into the backboard on that shot.
Foul's going to be on Takiula Ferenson, and Jeremiah Bailey's going to the line, and Bailey will have a chance to get his first points of the night. Bailey's free throw is up and around the rim and out. Jacob Tryon will get in for the Pilots, and Tryon takes over for Ferenson. Second free throw for Bailey is no good. Almost an ugly make, but it rattled out. 41-28, Pacific by 13. Adams up top, guarded by Bailey. Adams dribbles to the right elbow, pivots off his left foot, looking for a back cut from Isaiah White, and the ball went out of bounds. It was kicked out of bounds, I believe. 15 seconds on the shot clock, and it'll be a media timeout. As Harewood was set to check in, LeVar Harewood will get in when we come back after a timeout on the floor here from the Spano Center. This timeout comes with exactly 16 minutes to go in the second half. Pacific 41 and Portland 28 on the W.TV.
What is our way is unrelenting. Imposing as the mountaintops to our east, strong as the ocean to our west. Our way is forward, challenged by past achievement, expecting future success. Our way is committed, devoted, passionate. Our way fuels us to be different, to be inspired, to have faith in each other. What is our way is west.
Pacific 41, Portland 28, 16 minutes to go in regulation. Zach Beirute, the great Bob Thomason off to my right. And Jacob Tryon will inbound here for the Pilots. Tryon from baseline right will inbound to Walker, short right corner. Walker driving along the baseline, puts a floater up that's not good. It was well long. And Pacific has the miss. Moore takes into the front court. Moore will call up Gary Chavichian. Chavichian back to Moore. Now on the left angle to Jenkins. Passes to Bailey, who wasn't ready for it, and the ball goes out of bounds. Bailey was left of the lane, wasn't ready for that pass.
You know, he had his hands up, waiting for the pass. He hit him right in the hands and fumbled it out of bounds. You tell me, he hit him in a bad place. Right in the hands.
Right in the hands. As Adams on the mouth of the Power Cat. Guarded by Moore. Adams chest pass to his left to Walker. Walker guarded by Jenkins. Walker backpedaling, now cuts it to his left. He's going to take a three and knock it down. And look out, it's a 10-point game, 41-31.
The Tigers haven't played very well except that Seminoles start. They played really good. They've shut down since then.
Jenkins on the right side, up top to Moore. Moore bounce pass in the lane to Bailey, and Bailey has it knocked away by Diabate. Gets it back. Bailey trying to pass it out, but it's stolen by Walker. Walker into the front court with it. You don't want to give the Pilots a glimmer here if you're the Tigers. Pacific up by 10, 41-31. Adams chest pass to his left to Walker. Pilots now on a 7-0 run, trying to extend it, and driving baseline, Walker is fouled down low. And he is fouled by James Hampshire.
Next foul being 1-on-1.
Yeah, those fouls were accumulating fast, and Stoudemire's seen enough. It's going to be a line change. Finstoon, Tripp, Fritz, and Crockrell will get Moore, Bailey, Hampshire, and Jenkins. Baseline left, Tryon will look to inbound. He inbounds to Walker, left corner, and a whistle right at the inbound is going to be an illegal screen set by Diabate.
You can't set a good screen at this time of the year. Practicing all the time.
Brock, in the middle. You're in the middle, Brock.
So that might stymie some of the Portland momentum. They had a chance to make it a 9-0 run or more as they find Chavichian in transition for three. That is no good. Long rebound out to Jahlil Tripp, though. And for Tripp, that's his eighth board. So he's now two rebounds away from a double-double.
It's amazing. It's a three-point shot, and the two guards on the zone were all the way into 10 feet. If they just stay out there inside the three-point line, they get that rebound easy.
Chavichian up top to Crockrell with five to shoot. Pierre's going to put up a fall-away floater. It's no good. Well, short. He had to force it because the shot clock was under five. Adams will go toward the left wing, dribble to his right. Adams chest pass to his left to Walker. He'll take a step-back three, and that is around the rim and out. Dangerously close to a 10-0 Portland run there had he made it. See if the Tigers can rebound here as Crockrell on the left wing. Curls it into the lane, gives a nice bounce pass to Jahlil Tripp, who lays it up and out.
That's what the Tigers need, an easy basket inside.
A nice pass there by Pierre Crockrell, feathered that bounce pass between the defense. So Tripp with 18 points now, and he's got 9 rebounds. As on the right wing, it is Adams. Adams to Tryon. Tryon hands it off to Harewood, to Diabate. Diabate dribbles it into the baseline. Diabate going strong to the backboard, puts it off the glass and in. And he is going to the line as the foul is going to
nice
be on Shaquilo Fritz.
He faked the handoff that time, and they went to switch, and he just kept on going for a layup.
So Diabate is at the line, and he is not a very good free throw shooter. 54%, but he makes that one. So it's a 9-point game, 43-34. Portland on a 9-2 run over the last 5 minutes and change. Crockrell to Chavichian. Far corner to Finstoon. Back to Chavichian. To Crockrell, to Chavichian. Zings it down low to Finstoon, who shovels to a trailing Fritz, who has his shot blocked, but he is simultaneously fouled. And the foul's going to be on Diabate.
And it looked like a good block to me. I mean, there's a little contact, but I think when you block a shot, they always allow a little contact, if it's not with the hand.
Free throws up. And no good for Shaquilo. Pacific from the line in this game is 4 of 10. Second one is up and no good, so Fritz missed them both. He's now 14 of 28 from the line this season. Walker's going to pull up and knock it down, and this is now an 12-2 Portland run, and it's 43-36. Near corner, Chavichian for three, and he knocks it down. And boy, do the Tigers need that.
Well, they got Tripp in the high post area. Now he can score in there and pass from there, and they're going to be tough to handle with him inside there in that middle of that zone.
Chase Adams up top to Diabate. Diabate dribbles to his left, leaves it for Walker to Tryon on the right wing. To Harewood. Harewood curls the dribble to his left, now cuts it back to his right. Bounce pass to Tryon down low, and he runs into Gary Chavichian. They'll call an offensive foul. So the Tigers take it back with 12:22 to go in regulation. It's Tripp, Crockrell, Chavichian, Finstoon, and Fritz on the floor for Pacific. As they find Tripp in the high post, gives it back out to Crockrell to Finstoon on the left wing. Finstoon pass up top to Crockrell, dribbles to his right. Chavichian back to Crockrell to Jahlil Tripp. Tripp to Finstoon, a far corner three. Got it.
You know, Portland's zone is guarding the non-shooters and not guarding the shooters. You know, they don't have any concept of, like, who they should be guarding, who they shouldn't be guarding.
Portland's going to call a timeout as the Tigers have pushed back. The Pilots were working on that deficit with a 12-2 run. But to Pacific right now at this timeout, which will stretch to the media timeout, leads it 49-36. Coach Thomason and I are back after this on the W.TV.
Let's see what you got out there.
.11:54 to go in the second half. It's Pacific 49, Portland 36. Zach Bayrudy, Coach Thomason, glad to have you with us. Stick around following our game tonight, Pacific Courtside Live. We'll chat with our City of Stockton Human Resources hardworking player of the game. Also want to remind you that Lincoln Center is Stockton's premier shopping and dining destination. Enjoy boutique shopping, award-winning restaurants, and family-friendly atmosphere. Personal service is always in style at Lincoln Center, conveniently located at Pacific Avenue and Benjamin Holt here in Stockton. Pilots have the ball, and they move from our right to our left as Walker up top to LeVar Harewood. A pass down low is picked off by Finstoon to Crockrell, who crosses midcourt to Chavichian in the trailer, and in-rhythm three may have been partially blocked. It was well short, and the long miss goes out of bounds on the far sideline. Did you see anybody get a hand on that?
No, I didn't. I think he just rushed a little.
Back into the game for the Pilots, number three, Isaiah White.
When he's open and set and in good rhythm, I think he should shoot every shot when he's open. Sometimes he has a tendency to hunt for him and rush him.
Diabate inside the right wing, drives into the lane. Diabate goes over Fritz and banks it off the glass.
That was a good move. Changed his hand from right to left to right and made a banking shot.
Crockrell from our left to our right into the front court. By the way, Crockrell, five assists. His seventh game with at least five assists this season. As Finstoon up top to... Or that's the Tripp in the key. Tripp's got to drive it in. Tripp scoops it off the window. No, but Fritz is there to guide it right back up and in.
Portland's pretty small on the front line. You know, that they have some guards playing back. And once the center gets hooked up, there's no way you can box him out.
51-38 Pacific, 10:45 and counting to go in regulation. Ferenson baseline left. The jumper is an air ball. Tigers have the miss. Crockrell is going to give to Chavichian back up top to Pierre. A lob down low to Finstoon, who receives and then guides it up and in. Six assists for Pierre Crockrell, 53-38 Pacific. Again, Tripp needs one more rebound for his double-double tonight, would be his ninth of the season. His Walker, a left wing three, is too strong, and there it is, Tripp's 10th rebound and a double-double, another one for Jahlil. To Crockrell on the left side. Crockrell dribbles to his right. Crockrell lobs down low to Shaquilo Fritz. Fritz gives to, or tries to give to Crockrell, who is trailing. It's knocked away. The ball is loose on the floor. And a pile.
Fritz could need to go make a move right there. He got the ball in the low post. He's 6'8". Go make a jump hook like he did early. And he didn't need to be passing the cutting point guard. You know,
It's a jump ball. Possession arrow belongs to Portland.
Good hustle, though.
Yeah. .956 to go in this one. Pacific 53, Portland 38. On the out-of-town scoreboard as they get the floor mopped up. San Diego, an early 23-19 lead on Pepperdine in Malibu. LMU with a 14-12 lead, 9 minutes to go in the first half there on BYU. San Francisco has defeated Santa Clara 70-61. And Gonzaga, St. Mary's idle tonight as a foul away from the ball is going to be called on Brock Finstoon for a hold. And again, the Pilots are in the 1-1. That is the eighth team foul. Free throw is up and good for Walker, so he will get another. JoJo Walker is 4-4 from the line tonight. He has 13 points to lead Portland. Again, for Pacific, Jaleel Tripp leading the way with 18 points and 10 rebounds. 9th double-double of the season for Jaleel. Second one is up, and it is good. Inbound to Crockrell. Back it goes to Tripp as Tripp and Crockrell play catch. Now a pass ahead to Gary Chavichian inside the left wing. Chavichian pulls it back and gives to Crockrell. To Chavichian on the right wing. He'll take a three and knock it down. On balance for Chavichian, and that's his second made three of the game.
If he can't guard one pass on the best shooter in the zone, you should be playing zone. You get back out of man-to-man.
Adams dribbling toward the far sideline. Adams will go back to his left off a screen. Hesitation move. Lob it down low for a one-handed alley-oop, and the dunk missed by Theo Akuba, who had just checked in. And they're going to call foul here on Shaquilo Fritz. Was that on the shot, on the
kinda
dunk?
They said maybe a little undercutting action.
I guess he kind of...
Not much.
Not, yeah.
You got to look for stuff there. Referee has looked for stuff for that.
Free throw is up and no good. Chavichian's 10th game with at least three made threes. That was his third made three of the game. I think I said two. I shorted him one. But to Chavichian with 9 points in this game. Second one is up and good for Akuba. 56-41 Pacific by 15. 9-13 and counting to go in regulation. Crockrell to the right wing. Hands to Finstoon. Now up top to Chavichian. Chavichian to Crockrell up top. To Finstoon, curling at the left elbow. Turnaround jumper good. Is good.
Squared up. Came off that screen. Squared up very nicely.
Finstoon becomes the second Tiger player to reach double figures. He now has 11 on 5 of 7 from the floor. So a nice game tonight for Brock Finstoon. Far side Adams going to sling it back to Akuba, and Akuba traveled. He was near the right elbow. So Akuba traveled, and with 8:40 to go, the ball goes back to the Tigers, who lead it 58-41.
You hope this game, maybe. I don't know how McCray's doing tonight. You know, he's back suiting up. If he can play, you'd like to give him some minutes because it's going to take him to get back ready for the tournament at the end of the year to get back and playing for him.
Yeah, the thing with Amari McCray, he's been out with a nagging hamstring. He had tweaked his hamstring in practice last week warming up. So that's why he has been out, as Crockrell feeds it down low to Tripp, who has the ball stripped, and a scrum on the floor, and now it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Portland. And the shot clock reset to 30, and Terry Porter saying it's not a reset, so they're going to have to look at the shot clock here. By the way, 8 assists for Crockrell tonight. That ties a career high. So 15 seconds on the shot timer.
Shot clock not reset.
Baseline left, Crockrell will inbound. And he inbounds to Fritz, who tries to elevate for a dunk and is fouled. They stripped him, but he was fouled, and the foul is going to be on Chase Adams.
Yeah, I never liked leaving a post guy on a switch for an out-of-bounds play. I wanted our post guys to stay with the post guys because that's what happens. People go out, switch, and the big guys go right to the basket.
So you'd never switch on that?
Not big guy leaving his man. The other guard, two guards could switch. You know what I mean? But we played the play, but we never wanted the postman to be able to come back and get a layup or get a muscle shot inside.
Fritz makes the first free throw. He is now 1 of 3 from the line tonight. He had been 0 of 2. Second one is up and good for Shaquilo Fritz. 60-41. Pacific by 19, and this is Pacific's largest lead of the night. Adams into the front court, guarded up top by Moore. Adams chest pass to his right to Walker. Walker into the lane, puts it off the glass. No, rebound taken by Akuba. His shot may have been blocked by Fritz, but he was also fouled. And it is indeed a foul on Shaquilo Fritz. And it gets us to the under 8 media timeout in the second half, as this timeout comes with 7:59 to go in regulation. It's all Pacific right now. The Tigers 60 and the Pilots 41. And Coach T and I are back after this on the W.TV. .759 to go in regulation. Pacific 60 and Portland 41. You know, we talked about wanting to see some separation here for Pacific, and here you have it, 19 points.
That's the way it should be. Yeah. And I think they can win by 30 if they want to, but, you know, whether they do or not, that doesn't matter. You know, they just need to keep on playing good basketball and stay healthy and get through this game and get ready for St. Mary's.
Free throw for Akuba is up, and it is good. Do you look at the last 8 minutes of this game as kind of a, I don't want to say a dress rehearsal for St. Mary's, but, you know, they're getting kind of some momentum going for that game?
Well, I think the momentum is already happening. Well. I think right now what you want to do is you want to monitor Tripp as much as you can. You know, as soon as you can get him out of the game, don't have to use him anymore, you want to get him rested for St. Mary's.
Moore is going to break the press and give it to the near side to Finstun. The pass was deflected. Now Jenkins' shot from the free throw line is good. Finstun did a nice job to recover that ball and then get it to Jenkins.
You could probably take Tripp out right now, and maybe if you need to put him back in, you could, but probably don't have to. Give him as much rest, no ankle twist or anything.
This is White in the lane, puts it up, and it rattles out, and Tripp clamps his 11th rebound of the game. Pass across the way to Justin Moore. Moore is going to hand it to Finstun along the far sideline to Jenkins up top. Jenkins, bounce pass to his right to Moore, back to Danis. Danis going to go off the dribble left of the lane. Pull-up jumper is short. The rebound taken by Portland, taken by Akuba. ahead to Adams. Adams from the right angle is going to drive in underneath the bucket, give it out to Ferenson on the left wing. Ferenson to his right to Walker. Walker dribbles into the lane, scoops it high off the window, no good. Try to go over Hampshire, and it's really tough to do that. Hampshire's so big. Hampshire at 7'1". So on the right wing, it's Moore. Shot fake on a three. Moore guarded by Adams, backing his way down now. Moore stumbles and then turns the ball over to Akuba. To Adams on the left wing. Up top to White. White, a ball fake, drives in, tries to hand it off underneath to Akuba. Akuba under duress, finally gets a hold of it, tries to pass it out, and it's stolen by Jahlil Tripp. Tripp lobs down low to Finstum, but it's off
the
mark.
The right idea on that pass. That pass would not make me mad. I thought he threw it too hard, but it was the right pass if he just makes it real soft. Just kind of throw a little soft pass where it just feathers over the guy. He could have caught it and laid it up.
Jeremiah Bailey is going to check in here. And James Hampshire will check out. 62-43 Pacific by 19. Again, it matches their largest lead of the night. Adams drives in, kicks it out to Tryon, and now to Ferenson up top. Ferenson to his left, chest pass back to his right to Walker. Walker to Tryon inside the right wing. Tryon's going to give a bounce pass to a cutting Adams, and Adams goes up, has it stripped. I don't think he ever got a shot off. I think the ball just popped up in the air off the strip. As Moore on the left wing thought about a three, pulls it back down. Moore will dribble one time, hand it off to Jenkins. To Finstoon. Finstoon. Give to Moore, curling up near the right angle. 10 seconds to shoot. Moore crosses over. Four to shoot. Moore has to force it from the perimeter. It's an air ball. And then underneath, there's going to be a foul called on Jahlil Tripp. May have just kissed off the very front of the rim.
That was a poor possession. Moore, again, not handling the ball great during pressure, you know.
So Pierre Crockrell and his eight assists are back in.
I definitely get Tripp out of the game with four fouls now. I mean, you don't want him fouling out with 19-point lead. Then you don't have him if you need him.
We'll see how long Jahlil will stay in there. He's got 18 and 12. Again, his ninth double-double of the season.
I'd be more worried about him rolling an ankle.
Free throw is up and no good for Isaiah White. And here he comes. Jahlil is out of the game now as Austin Vereen will check in. White now 3 of 5 from the line, by the way.
He's got 40 minutes to play Saturday night.
Yeah, he does.
Get some rest.
Second one for White is good. Again, Pacific and St. Mary's, 5 p.m. Be back on Fox Sports AM 1280 for that. 5 p.m. is the tip from Moraga. Pre-game show begins about 4:45. So an early-ish start on Saturday is Danis Jenkins. Jenkins up top looking to his left, now dribbles to his right with a crouch and a whistle away from the ball. There's going to be a holding foul here on Portland with 5:17 to go. And the foul is going to be on Chase Adams. Free throw is up and good for Pierre Crockrell, the front end of the 1-1, so he'll get another. That was the eighth team foul on the Pilots. Checking the out-of-town scores, LMU and BYU are going blow for blow in the first half. 23-22 BYU as Crockrell able to make the second, was hanging on the rim for some time. But BYU leading by one at the under four media timeout. Driving through traffic and putting it up and in is Isaiah White. Nice drive by Isaiah White with the right hand.
I like him.
64-46 Pacific is Crockrell to Finstoon up top. Finstoon to Crockrell on the left wing. Pierre dribbles to his right. Now to his left, gives a bounce pass to Jenkins, curling at the left elbow, gives to Crockrell, passes in the right corner to Finstoon, back to Pierre, it goes up top. Back to it, Jenkins. Jenkins gonna drive it in, give a bounce pass down low to Finstoon, who got his shot blocked. The loose ball is gonna go out of bounds.
That was a really nice pass and good put up. And the center made a nice play on blocking the shot there. It was all good.
Guard. Ferenson up top gives to his left to Tryon. Tryon dribbles to his right. He's going to hand it off to Walker. Walker on the left wing gives it back up top to Adams. Adams driving down right of the lane, tries to feed Tryon in traffic, and he can't catch it. It's knocked away, stolen. Crockrell on ahead. Crockrell's going to go right to the bucket and lay it up and in. So this is now a 20-point spread in Pacific's largest lead of the contest. Actually, it does match their largest lead. They were up 64-44 just a few moments ago. And now a turnover by the Pilots. They tried to hit White in the near corner, and it goes off his hand and out of bounds. LeVar Harewood is back in for Portland. Finstoon up top to Jenkins. Danis chest pass to Crockrell inside the top of the key. Give and go from Bailey. Crockrell is moving to his left now. Passes to his right to Jenkins. He takes a jumper from just inside the right elbow. That's no good, but Finstoon out of nowhere gets the offensive rebound for a reset. Lobs it out to Crockrell. Crockrell will move to his left. Crossover, take a jumper from inside the left wing that's no good, and the rebound taken by Tryon as he tightropes the end line. Gives it out far side to Chase Adams. Adams drives through traffic. Tough shot hanging in the air. Puts it up no, and the rebound for Jeremiah Bailey to Finstoon. Finstoon up the far left sideline. Finstoon's stagger step. He's going to go to the bucket, put it off the window, and
nice
in.
Nice move.
So this is now Pacific's largest lead, 22 points, 68-46, with the 2:50 and counting to go in the second half. Driving baseline left is Harewood. He puts it up over Vereen. The shot doesn't go, but Vereen commits the foul. And that will take us to our final timeout on the floor. With 2:47 to go in this one, Pacific up by 22. The Tigers 68 and the Pilots 46 on the W.TV. All Pacific here tonight. The Tigers 68, the Pilots 46 with 2:47 to go in this one. If you're hungry, head over to Lincoln Center, the corners of Pacific Avenue and Benjamin Hold Drive, with over 20 eateries and restaurants, from fine dining to burgers and fries. Three new restaurants that are set to open this winter. They've got the cure to curb your hunger at Lincoln Center. Tigers on the brink of a 20-win season. They're 2:47 from it. And Harewood is at the line. His first free throw is up and short. Second one is up and no good, and the rebound taken by Vereen. To Crockrell, who gives to Jenkins, who is undercut by Harewood. And Jenkins took a tumble. Harewood, nice enough to help him up. So the foul is on Harewood.
That's exactly why sometimes you don't want to start her out there in the last 2 minutes of this game. And it's not like anybody did anything wrong. It just could be a freak accident.
Free throw is up and good for Danis Jenkins. He's the front end of the 1-1, so he will get another. This will be the first 20-win season for the Tigers since Coach Thomason led the team to the NCAA tournament 2012-13. Second one is up and good for Danis.
It's always good to win 20 games.
Yeah. 70-46. 2:36 and counting to go in this one. To Walker. Walker on the right wing. Walker guarded by Vereen's going to take a deep three and knock it down. That one rattled through. So JoJo Walker makes it 70-49. Pilots will pressure in the backcourt. Crockrell trapped in the far corner. Tries to pass it across the way, and it got deflected. Hit off the top of the backboard. So it'll stay with the Tigers.
You don't want to catch in the corner, and they dribble the ball, and he's fading out of bounds. Let's throw the pass. You got to be strong.
Corey Rooks will check into the game for Pacific. Always great when the walk-ons get some time. It's Corey looking for his first points of the season. Rooks played at Gonzaga the last few seconds of that game. As Vereen gives it near midcourt to Crockrell. Jenkins, by the way, is the guy who checked out for Pacific as we tick under 2 minutes to go in this one. Rooks setting a screen. Crockrell will give it to Rooks down the baseline. He's going to take it and make it. Corey's first career points. The bench gets excited for him.
Awesome.
Walker in transition is going to take a left wing three, and that is around the rim and out. And Corey pulls down a rebound.
He'll say, hey, he should be playing more. Look at all the points he scored and rebounds he would have got.
Freshman from Memphis, Tennessee. Great to see Corey in there. He had a bad miss at Gonzaga. He missed a shot that was hit the top of the backboard. He got a hard time about it afterwards. As Crockrell gives it back to Rooks. Thought about a three and traveled. Corey wanted to shoot, thought better of it. Probably should have taken it.
Yeah, the shot fake was good. Just keep your foot down. Don't travel. You might have got a dunk.
72-49. With a minute 15 and counting to go in the second half. It's on the right wing. Adams is going to take a three, and that is short. The rebound taken by Finstoon.
The rebound separation in this game has got to be unbelievable.
Well, I'll tell you, it's 36-21, 37-21. So Crockrell near center court will dribble as much clock as he can. There's 11 seconds left on the shot timer. Crockrell to his right, slings it back to Rooks, a left wing three, and that is banked in! Attaway, TK.
Attaway.
Now, right corner three is good for Wyatt Watson. He's playing in his eighth game, native of Bellingham, Washington. 75-52. As we are now inside of 30 seconds to go.
They're just going to take a violation here.
As Sotomayor is saying, just hold it. Finsu's going to shoot it. And that's going to hit off the bottom of the backboard. And Sotomayor upset. He didn't want him to shoot it. I don't think Finstoon heard. As the crowd was chanting UOP.
Sometimes there's confusion. Sometimes it's better to call a color, like you just call green or a color, and that means what? You don't shoot the ball and you take a violation. So then everybody's clear about it. When you're saying don't shoot, does that mean with 1 second just get the shots, you don't turn the ball over yourself? I can understand why he did that.
JoJo Walker hit a three, pulling up, and that's going to be the final made shot of this game and make it look a little bit better for Portland. It's a 20-point win for the Tigers. Congratulations to Pacific, a 20-win season. 75-55, you know, looks a little bit closer for the Pilots, but this one was dominated by Pacific.
Once you win by 20, you dominate.
Yeah, this was dominated by Pacific. Another win for the Tigers, their fifth consecutive victory, and again, first time the Tigers have won 20 games in a season since Coach Thomason's tournament team did it 2012-13. And it'll be a happy edition of Pacific Courtside Live. We'll talk with Jaleel Tripp, our City of Stockton Human Resources hardworking player of the game, another double-double. And we'll also talk with Coach Stoudemire as Pacific Courtside Live coming up next. Our final score, Pacific 75, Portland 55, and a post-game show next on the W.TV.
We, the student athletes,